So this is my Senior Assassin videos. There are three parts, and whatever part you're watching right now, I advise you watch the first part, and then the second part, and then the third part. So watch it in order. If you don't know what Senior Assassin is, don't worry, I'm gonna explain it for you. There are teams of either one or two. In my case, I was on a team of two, me and Natasha. The person who organized the whole thing gives each team targets, which would be other teams of one or two. There was a time limit on how long you had to get your targets out, also known as rounds. And if you didn't get them out in that time period, you would automatically be out of the game. You can't just go around getting random teams out. You have to get your target. In the beginning of the game, if your teammate got out, you'd have to get your assassin in order to revive your partner. But in part two, the rules change, and if your partner got out, you had 24 hours to get both of your targets in order to revive them. While you are trying to get your targets, you have an assassin coming after you. They can get into your backyard, stake out your house, wait outside of your work. There are certain places they can't get you. They can't get you in any religious building. They can't come into your work. They can't come into your house without an invitation, like Vampire Diaries. The game ends when there is only one team left, which would be the winner, who would receive the money prize of almost $1,000.
I hope that I explained it decently well. If I didn't, I'm so sorry, but it apparently not all schools do it, so apparently some schools do it, some don't. But this clip will be in the beginning of every video so that I can explain how this game works. So I hope you enjoy the video. Let's go. Hey vlog. So this is the look that I'm going for.
I have to change into this after work so that no one sees that it's me walking out of my job, so that no one shoots me with a water gun. And if my mom made a great point, so I have heels on, my heels. She said, well, what if you want to run in them? And I'm like, if they get me, there's just no point in running. Like, I'm just not gonna run. Like, it's just, I'm taking the L. So every single time I leave the house during Senior Assassin, I will be in a wig and a hat and just glasses.
The plan here is, I'm gonna walk in to my work, because it starts at 12, so I'm safe when I go into work. Anyways, I'm gonna go into work with this bag filled with all of my stuff that I need. Now, if the person I've created goes out with this bag, no. So, also in this bag, it's gonna be this fold-up bag so that I can put this bag in this bag when I leave. I'm so excited, but not really, because I'm also kind of scared that my boss is gonna be like, what is wrong with you? What's wrong with you?
All right, I'm in my mom's car because I'm gonna drive her car to work so that no one sees me. So I haven't driven this in months. Let's not crash.
I showed my boss. I was like, hey, this is what I'm doing. She was like, oh my God, you look perfect. Like someone who would fit into my town, but not me. So apparently I pulled it off, and I don't even know if someone was out to get me. I mean, if someone was, I didn't see them. But I don't really know if anyone was. And I don't know if I can drive in heels. So I might, not bad.
Someone already got out. It's 2 hours in. It's been 2 hours and someone already got out. I thought that was gonna be me, but it's not me.
Oh my God. It is like 9:30. About probably like a half hour to an hour ago, Natasha got out of Senior Assassin. I was explaining to the vlog, explaining to the people that Natasha got out like a couple hours in. No. Like really? Really?
Hi guys. So, I got out. Basically, I was at this party and I had like this gut feeling. I was like, oh, I'm gonna get out. Let me know why I'm sitting on someone's like steps.
Which way, right or left?
Go straight.
Got it.
I'm sitting on someone's steps and all of a sudden I feel a tap on my shoulder. I'm like, he goes, I'm so sorry I have to do this.
I should insert the video.
And
insert here.
I got him.
I'm sorry.
And basically then he put a hole in a water bottle and he got me out. I was so mad. So now guess what?
He was polite though.
He did it very respectfully. I'm not gonna lie.
We just stalked him. I found out where he lived.
And we found out he doesn't have a gate.
I have to get 4 people out now. So 2 of our targets and then 2 of the people who got her. But I can't have the people who have her, who have the people who got her. They can't get her them out. That makes sense?
Guys, basically, we thought our target. We thought we just saw our target. But no, it was her friend bringing her Dunkin'.
She wanted me to jump.
So I made her jump into the seat. The passenger
We gotta duck down.
The current setup. Okay, so do you want to get back in the driver's seat and just drive?
Sure.
But I don't want your hair to be seen. Put this on your head.
I'm gonna stay in the back seat while you drive.
This is a joke. I spotted the person that got me out. Just ran after him.
I forgot my keys.
I lost her shoe.
My foot.
I can't.
I need my shoe back.
Okay, well, we're going to his house and we're gonna hide in his bushes. He's right there. Just hide back. Sit back. Hide. We gotta hide. His parents can't see us either. Wait. No. Take your keys off, bitch.
I need a fucking
microphone. Okay. See, I don't want his parents to see us though. And then squirt when I say squirt. We're walking and I have to go have my Mother's Day lunch.
We secured the shoe! But no herons.
We're stalking out of his house right now. And he's at the window. And
he's at the window.
Natasha thinks that he's like going somewhere.
Yeah, that's like what's in my brain. Yeah, anyway, not running barefoot. That's insane.
I walked a while. I walked a while barefoot, as you could see in the other clips. But I got my running shoes on.
She's ready.
I got these running shoes ready to get you, Aaron.
We have some key information
from gang. So basically,
oh my god, Commodore.
Miss Michaela.
Say the full government name.
No, well, this is coming out afterwards, anyways.
I know, but still.
Miss Michaela gave me some key information for some more key information.
Well,
so when you see this, I'm sorry, Nicole and Alyssa.
I don't know when this is coming out. It might come out before senior session ends. If I get out.
Oh, well then it doesn't matter because we'll already be out. So sorry, Nicole and Alyssa, if you guys are out because of me. I needed
That's
to
hard.
Get revived. You know, you have no friends in this game. So basically, she told me that Alex always leaves her house.
That's our original target.
Should I she told us about where they work. She told us if they have senior leave. What? None of them have senior leave or late arrival. And yeah, that's kind of all we need because we know everything else.
And we just saw, so we have this guy, Arvind.
To revive me.
He's literally not even our target. But we're stalking out his house because his car, whatever, whoever car it is, left. And we just saw his dad unlock the door. So that basically means that no one's home. So we're staking out his house until wherever his car is comes back.
Isaiah's been stalking Michaela, she said.
Michaela.
And you know who's been telling? Really? Kira's been telling Isaiah everything about them.
Oh, backstabber!
Should we go up to the door and be like, "Hi, is Arvind home?"
I mean, they basically know. Arvind knows that we're coming for him. He knows that we don't have him as a target. That we're coming for him.
Should I ask his dad?
Yes. He's so sure.
I should be like, I have I should be like,
I'm in one of his classes.
I'm in one of his classes, and I had the presentation thing to drop off.
What are you gonna drop off?
No, I should be like, "Hi, I'm with Miss Hutchin High School. We're doing a fundraiser." I'm with blank high school. I was wondering if you have any students from Miss Hutchin High School that are in your household. And I just come to know.
We need a better place.
If he says no, that means he's not here and that we can stay here till he gets home.
Okay, no, but we need a plan, not that. So you're gonna go up to him and knock on the door and be like, hey, is Arvind home? Does he play tennis?
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh no, it's not there.
Oh my god, my heart keeps jumping, bro. My heart keeps jumping.
So we have intel from Aliza. We love Aliza.
We heart Aliza right now. So
we love her.
Basically, we're sitting outside of darn it of Arvind's house, and we're like, we know nothing about this boy. Let's call Aliza. Turns out she's in a tennis group chat, and he has a meet tomorrow and has to be at the school. He has to be at the school at 7. Those are my feet. Has to be at the school at 7:15.
That was 7:15
to 7:30. So
we at his house at 6:30 in the morning.
We're gonna be at his house at 6:45 in the morning. We left Arvind's and he went back while we left. So we're just gonna get him tomorrow morning.
Oh my god, I haven't been this early up this early in a very long time. I'm freaking exhausted. It is 6:26 in the morning. Oh my god, I am so tired. We're gonna go get this man, and then we're going to Duncan, and then we're gonna get his teammate, and we're doing this morning, because I did not wake up early as hell to not get this man today. Both of them, I want them today. oh my god. Get in the car.
Oh my god, guys. I'm a morning.
Put your car in the back seat.
My car.
You can put your backpack in the back seat.
Guys, I'm a morning person who wakes up every day at 4 a.m. and I go bike riding.
We're behind the tree.
Go.
Holy.
We got him!
He's driving out now, but we literally, what time is it? It's 7:17, bro.
We are currently stalking outside Aaron's house right now.
I got my locked and loaded.
Oh my god, I really wish y'all knew.
Oh my god, window, I see. I feel bad. He literally, I went in his backyard and just kept shooting at him.
They just kept going back and forth. I was like, there's no difference, y'all.
Natasha survived. Slay. Oh my goodness. He's claiming that I didn't get him out, which is, it's fine because now we don't have like someone trying to assassinate us for the rest of the round.
The person who's running it, Steve, took him off of us. So like.
So now no one has us.
Unless we get our target and their partner comes for us.
This turned into so much more than it needed to. Came to the conclusion, Natasha's back in. I don't really care about anything else. And he can't come after us anymore or something. So we have, like, no person targeting us. And I was like, all right, I'm chilling with that. Someone finds the video of me going after him. It gets sent in the group chat that we have for Senior Assassin. And most people were on my side saying that I got him and everything, but some people were just like, you can't see it. And I was just like, we came to a conclusion hours ago before y'all even knew about this. So I was just like, so there was a whole argument going on for hours, and I was just like, we came to the conclusion forever ago, like, I don't know why we're still arguing about this. So we're gonna go get a target, and Natasha has a water gun,
and then we have
finally
then we only have 24 hours to not get hit by the other one.
We okay, so we just hide out for 24 hours?
I have work tomorrow too.
it's a new rule, and it's that the revival period is only within 24 hours.
We are stocked outside of Kayla's house right now trying to get her, but I feel like...
That's so funny, though.
Okay.
How this is literally a game of who can stalk better.
We are
even though stalking's literally illegal.
Guys, I have a pen.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2.
Yes!
Becky, look at her butt. It is so big.
You get sprung and ask you the disco lights. You gotta pack much bags. So
fellas, yeah. Fellas, yeah. We were sitting at Kayla's. We were deciding, oh, maybe she's at work. Let's leave. We see her car at the stoplight. Sammy Gross. Make this right. No, not into here.
I know that one.
Yeah. So now we're trying to find out where she's going. Maybe she's going to her Target's house so we can at least figure out who her Target is. I mean, her Target is.
If she went straight, which way should we be going?
I'm going to sit. She's right there.
Wait. She's right there. Going to Walgreens. Wait. Let's go.
Oh, my God.
Caleb's about to get got.
They are right inside there. Oh, my God. We're getting them right here, right now.
Is that them? I'm going. You ready? You got this. Go.
No!
I'm so sorry.
So I'm outside Natasha's house right now because I'm making sure that Alex doesn't show up and just like get her out. Because if she comes and she gets out of her house, if she gets out of her car, you're crazy. I'm gonna get you first. And then we move on. Well, if we stay safe for the next 24 hours, we're on to the next round. Because hopefully Steve doesn't assign us a new assassin. Because if he does, that'll be interesting. And we don't want that.
I'm home, safe and sound. Now I just have to make it to tomorrow at 6:40.
Okay, so basically, these two people got out. And one of them is really mad, but one of them is friends with Alex, who is coming to get me in redemption for Kayla. So she's on her way. Oh my God, I can't speak English. She's on her way to my house right now, apparently. So I don't know what she thinks I'm doing at 10 p.m., but I'm home chilling with my dad and my sister, and Natasha's on her way. We chilling with Pops.
Hello.
Who's the one?
Look at the bun. Look at turn the head.
You don't need
turn the head.
You don't need. Oh.
Can we talk about they're right outside my house? They're right by my car. I'm basically locked in my house.
Okay, so basically, she was literally stalked out in front of my house on the live. You can see, she was hiding behind my dad's car. She's gonna wake up early. I'm gonna be out. I'm waking up early so I can leave. I'm gonna leave way before she even gets here.
Leia is helping them, even though she's saying that she's helping us. And she texted Natasha and was like, did you get them? And then Natasha texted her and was like, no, I'm home. So now they're at her house.
Morning, it's 6:45. I'm about to leave because I'm not getting caught lacking. My alarm just went off. So it is officially 6:45 and I gotta get going. Do I know what I'm gonna do for the next 2 hours? Not really. I think I'm gonna go like chill at a park in my car. I'm not getting out my car. Made it to my car safe and sound. We're gonna leave and I don't know what we're gonna do. Let's drive around a little. I don't know yet. That's the exciting part. See, I was gonna get here like kind of like I was gonna go to this park kind of early, but then I kind of was like, no, I was driving around, but I was gonna like edit a video or something, but that's just not gonna happen. So we're gonna go to Dunkin', but we're gonna go through a drive-thru because I am not gonna get caught at Dunkin'. Yeah. So we're gonna go through a drive-thru, which is near my house. But It's like 7:35. School starts at 8:30.
I usually leave my house at like 7:45 to go get Dunkin'. So, maybe I should wait a little.
Y'all, I'm at a red light, don't worry, but I got my latte. Life is better. Oh my God.
So I have to go get to work before they get out of school so they can't get me. And then I'm taking my car and I'm parking in the back so that they're gonna go back there and wait for me outside. And then I'm gonna park in the back but I'm gonna lock up through the front in my disguise and my sister's gonna pick me up.
I'm at my job. I literally feel like a stuck egg, but we're gonna figure this out and we're gonna get out of here alive. Y'all, I'm ready. I'm ready to run, baby. I'm ready to run.
So this is the look.
We made it in the car, safe and sound. My sister's walking in my car to bring it to my house, and I'm just kind of chilling.
Why is it so freaking cold, man?
I'm gonna head home, and I'm staking it out. That's what I'm doing for the rest of the night. I am just not leaving my house.
I came home safe and sound, and now, so they came to my house and stalked out my house and then went to Natasha's and stalked out her house, and she's at her grandma's, so they found out that she was, you know, staying over at her grandma's. So yeah, tomorrow morning is gonna be fun. I literally just have to make it to school. That's all I have to do, and I'm safe. That's it.
Sorry, a bunny just like zoom. We got out of my house safely. It is 6:28 in the morning. I'm taking this seriously. No one is about to get me. No one. My sleep schedule is like, I feel like this is kind of good for me because like I have to get up and I have to leave early. So yeah, maybe I'll start going to the gym in the morning. Let's not lie to myself. I'm gonna go to a park and park in, it's like a big park. And I'm gonna park in one of the parking lots. There's like 5 of them. And I'm just gonna chill and edit a video, I'm thinking. Or maybe work on my psychology project that I have to do. So yeah, I feel like I'm being productive. Maybe I'll read, you know, who knows? The possibilities are endless. All right, we just got my latte from the drive-thru. Yum, yum, yum. Now we're off to school, I guess. We made it to school, safe and sound. Yay. We made it out safe! It's 6:49 right now. I stayed at work and cleaned until like 6:40. Yeah, I stayed till like 6:40. And then I got ice because I could walk around town. I am safe until Sunday because I have no assassin coming after me. It's too late to revive Kayla, so Alex isn't coming after me. Basically, guys, we got through the first round. We got through the first round. Yes. I can sleep in. I can go to my Dunkin'. I don't gotta go to that drive-thru, even though they do make a pretty good latte. I miss my girl at Dunkin' who knows my order like that. And then Saturday, I don't have to worry because I have work. And I do not have to worry about, like, coming out and, like, worrying someone's gonna get me. Like, I don't gotta worry about none of that.
Okay. Kara got out her Target.
Okay, so we pull up to my usernames.
Yeah.
Okay. We pull up to I'm not gonna expose her because she has nothing to do with it. The house that they were at. My Targets were at their Target's house. So then Katie got out of the car and chased Cooper.
Which was one of their Targets.
Which was one of our Targets. But Katie's slow. So she's normally not. I don't know what happened to her. She's been lug day a lot this week. So Katie lost Cooper, and then as we were losing Cooper, I was in the car still driving. I saw Andrew going around the corner. So then I sped up my car. I was going like way too fast for a back road in my session with a dead end. And I stopped the car at the corner, and as he came around, I jumped out of my car while it was in drive, jumped back in my car, put it in park, got out of the car, and shot him. And then as I'm running after him, shooting him, literally watching the water droplets get on his back, he's like still running. And I'm like, dude, I got you. I got you. Hello, I got you. Yeah. And then we had to take a picture, and I'll show you the picture.
No, 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 but you have to say, you have to say what you said to him. And the voice, too.
What was it again?
Track star.
How's it feel to be, what was it?
Non-athlete.
How's it feel to be killed by a, or I was like, I was like, track star, how's it feel to be killed by a non-athlete?
No, you have to do it in the voice.
Track star, how do you feel to be killed by a non-athlete? And then this is my photo.
Basically, so me and Natasha, we're gonna go get Alex today. I like left school early. I'm genuinely like sick right now, but it's fine. But we were still gonna go get her. But then. So Alex got her target. I don't know. That's just how it works. And so the partner is trying to revive the one that she killed. So he's on his way to her house, and me and Natasha are like, you know what, let's just let him vibe. Doesn't matter. So now he's gonna go. Darling, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you.